Well, hello again, friends and fans. Raptor here, and the time has finally come. Hello again, friends and fans. Raptor here, and welcome finally to the beta, the playable beta, for the wonderfully fantastic and long-awaited Steel Division Normandy 44. We're playing against the Scots here today as we're playing as the 12th SS Panzer, and we're going to be defending this area, this factory area, just after Normandy. Folks, let's go ahead and get this one up to 1,000 likes. Go ahead and use your voting power now if you want to see more of this on the channel. I guarantee you we can do it in the first hour to show Eugen that we want much more of this fantastic game and games like it. If you were a fan of Metal War Assault Squad, you're going to love this. If you were a fan of Wargame Red Dragon, you're going to love this. So right now, we're playing a conquest mode where we need to push the enemy's front line back and make sure that they don't capture this area. So the 12th SS, as you would imagine, the SS Panzer Brigade or Division is very skilled at, of course, tanks, whatever else. So we've got a lot of Panzer Grenadiers here who are going to fight fiercely in these factory buildings and, of course, setting up ambushes and AT traps and all sorts of great stuff, including that wonderful pack gun right there, 50mm, that's going to devastate the enemy. We've got enemy contacts already, speaking of the enemy, and we're going to set up a few recon units here to scout out the area. So we're playing in very slow right now against the AI, so I can take some time to explain how everything works here. We're going to put this recon unit in that building so they're in good cover, and we're going to get these two squads of SS infantry into these buildings to defend. There's also a commander here in this Kubel that we're going to have hop out into that factory building there, and you can see his sphere of influence, which basically keeps these troops under control, or at least has them fight longer and harder and more dedicated to the cause in a defensive position such as this. Over on the right side, we see an enemy tank approaching already. We better crack it. So we've got ourselves that wonderful 50mm AT gun that's got a five-man crew over here. You can see them setting up in the woods, and they're going to go ahead and take out this tank as soon as it's within range. So the infantry is now taking up good positions here and is going to hop into that building so we can provide overwatch for those troops that are in defensive positions. All right, let's get everything defense positions up. The enemy's coming. We're fighting against the Scots here today. The Scots have a lot of good mechanized units that are very light and very fast. You can recognize some of them here by their silhouettes. For example, we see the Bren carrier here and a few other troop transports on the left side. So you can play as the Americans, you can play as the Canadians, you can play as the British, you can play as the Germans, and all the different types of units and doctrines and such are available in the game, as well as some very nice pre-order bonuses. In fact, if you would like to play it now, it is available to play. So long as you pre-order it, you can download the beta now. All right, so it looks like that tank is firing against us. The PAC-38 50mm is under attack. Look at this beautifully done map as well. Look at that. Oh, the crew was killed in the tank. Our first kill of the war, folks. Fantastic. I was a part of the VIP beta, and I've got to say they've made some very good improvements, very fun improvements here. We're going to continue to play in slow motion so I can explain everything happening here. You see, as the enemy tank here is approaching, or at least in this case, enemy armored car, the Humber Mark III, the enemy is pushing the line forward, and they're gaining more points by doing so. Of course, this is an attack mode where you need to push the front line. There's no capturing zones. There's no killing enemy units. It's about outflanking and surrounding the enemy. Beautiful, that PAC gun right there, that PAC-38, doing a great job against the enemy. The nice thing, too, about this game is for those of you who played Men of War Assault Squad, or actually, I should say, Wargame Red Dragon, you can make your own custom decks, which are known as battle groups here. And vehicles do take damage, such as Men of War Assault Squad. For example, here the track's broken, more like the wheels destroyed or something like that on this Humber. And we're going to send out this Panzer Grenadier group to see if they can fire a Panzerfaust at the side of that. Look at that fuel explosion on that vehicle, and they are done. And that basically their advance here stops and is pushed back to where it was before. Intense infantry battles in the center here. We can call out flamethrower units. We can call out anti-tank units. We can call out even this. Look at this beautiful autocannon firing off on that group. They're not even going to stand a chance. We got Scots out in the open. Holy crap. All right, we're defending on all fronts. So yes, you can make your own battle groups. You can pick between all the different types of doctrines and stuff. There's even aircraft that you can call out. And this game works in phases, so there is so much to explain here, folks. I'm going to be doing some deck building very soon as well on the channel. So again, if you're new here, go ahead and subscribe so that way you can see how it's done. We're going to show you the do's and do-nots of deck building here, at least the basics, and so many of you will turn out to be so much better than I ever could be. So I'll be learning a lot from you. An enemy heavy tank here, it looks like. Churchill 4, or 5 rather, is sitting right there on the road. That's no good. We better get this 222 out of here. It's never going to stand a chance against a unit such as that. So again, we can bring out aircraft. In this case, I've got a BF-109 G2 BR-21, which can fire some rockets. Very good at emplacements such as enemy AT guns. And speaking of AT guns, I think we're going to need much more. Bren carrier right here. Let's go ahead and hit him with our Panzerfaust. Oh, that unit actually surrendered. Yes, they can actually surrender too. Whoa, that's unfortunate. Units seem to surrender sometimes of their own free will for whatever reason. 10 men there just immediately surrendering to a vehicle and such like that. So, all right, we got to get some more troops up then to fight them. So as you see over on this left side, this clock will fill up and we'll get 70 points every time that clock refills. And as I was saying about phases, as time goes on, the battle will unlock new units for us, such as, for example, the PAC-40 rather than the PAC-38, and we'll get bigger and better tanks that we can bring to the front line. So much more we can use to crush the enemy. Looks like right now they're trying to crush us in the center. We better bring in that armored car to decimate some of their light units. And we're going to have to deal with that Churchill as well as a beautiful flank on the left side. They're really getting under our skin over here. So let's call up some Panzer Grenadiers. And this game, by the way, can be played up to 10 versus 10. You can have 20 people on the battlefield. Can you imagine the D-Day landings in a 20-player battle? 10 v 10. The beaches are all just full up of troops, and everyone's trying to push off and hold the Allies back as the Allies are trying to scramble to gain dominance over the battlefield. Over here, they're trying to gain dominance at the factory. Tracks are broken on that Bren carrier. That thing's not going to stand a chance. Plus, we got that commander there, which is another great way to stop your troops from surrendering. And it looks like our anti-tank gun is, yep, looks like that was finally destroyed by all that advancing infantry. So we better do something to deal with all that. We can bring up a anti-tank gun to deal with that. Oh, that thing is going to last for a while. We got about 5 minutes to last here before we can call up some better units. Let's bring out our Panzerfuhrer here. 222 is now down as well. Anti-aircraft, the recon squad doing a good job of looking over that. Oh, they're trying to kill that 222. All right, we're going to put our units in some defensive positions here on the flank. Let's get our Opel Blitz trucks to flank these 10 soldiers here, and let's get the commander into the area. So you got to really work fast and think quickly on your feet here in these types of games. And I've never excelled at that. I've never been good at these games. I'm the worst ever. But I like to explain it, and it is very easy to learn and become better at with practice. And so, of course, it could be 10 games or 100 games, and eventually you'll become better. That pesky heavy tank on that left side, those Scots are really getting under my skin there, and they're actually getting a lot more points than we are. So we better quickly cut off that left flank and start to try to move in on some of these troops over here. So we got two command units moving in here on this left flank, and I'm trying to make it so that way they don't advance. Here we go, some of our troops bailing out already. We got to get into these buildings here to fight against these Scots. There we go. All right, now we've got all these troops pinned down. We've got about 4 minutes. Let's get some more infantry on this flank. Looks like this will be the last infantry we call up on the left flank. And we're definitely going to need it over there. Over here, it looks like they're bringing up some anti-aircraft units. Oh no, it was a Bren carrier. I thought it may have been one of those GMCs. All right, Panzer Grenadiers are destroyed. A lot of action going on here. I better think quick and bring out some more of these. These light armored vehicles are very good. All right, looks like they destroyed one of those. Those things are extremely effective. We got a half track here firing on the enemy units, trying to push out of that area. MG-34 possibly mounted on there. And it looks like we've got their flank to turn around now. Very good. All right, over on the right side, we're keeping their tanks at bay. So let's push up with this infantry here. Maybe we can get up to the port and capture that. Push the enemy's front line back a little bit. Meanwhile, we're going to push up on this right side then. See if we... Oh, wait, that enemy tank's coming close. Hold on. All right, we're losing a lot of Panzer Grenadiers here. Let's get these soldiers evacuated here. And same here. All right, we're going to really hold the hard left side since we're being pushed back there. And it's about 3 minutes until we get more reinforcements, so we better continue to bring up command units. And we need to deal with that enemy tank there, and the best way to do that is going to be with some sort of anti-tank. But I think calling up anything now with 3 minutes remaining might be a little too premature. Uh-oh, that tank's actually coming up, and it's going to kick our butt if we're not careful. We better stay in the trees and wait to ambush him. If that tank doesn't have recon to assist it, it's basically a rolling blind vehicle. It can't see anything that's in front of it, and it could be attracted right into a trap. Looks like they've set up an anti-aircraft gun out there as well, a tri-poiston, which is not very good. It's actually like a manually loaded gun. For those of you who know a lot about World War II, this is definitely, especially the vehicles, this is definitely going to be a wondrous game for you to play. All right, looks like a lot of enemy units are moving out into the open. We're going to now start engaging them. Very good. Enemy units starting to eliminate them. Looks like they got one of our recon squads there. Wow, they're just darting across there, aren't they? All right, let's eliminate this Bren carrier. And that infantry oop. All we gotta do is hold this position. All right, oh, an enemy command carrier has been knocked out and really pushing that front back. Let's go ahead and see if we can envelop this, you see this Bren carrier, or this Churchill now there. Let's go ahead and see if we can bring these two armored vehicles up behind it with the half track and see if we can use these vehicles to cut them off completely. They've got an AT gun over here. Let's go ahead and hit that with our 10 infantrymen. We've got Panzer Grenadiers coming into flank. And it looks like they're trying to hit our armored vehicles there, so that's what they were setting that up for. Luckily, we came up behind it, and they didn't even see it. LMG is firing off right now. Weapon status is firing on that gun. Let's continue to harass that gun. They got infantry fleeing from there. And a huge flank from the enemy. It's very difficult to eliminate that Churchill like that. So the enemy's got a very good advantage here at the start. But we're trying to close the gap. We've got these units here, I guess, advancing in reverse into the battle. But I guess you don't get to pick sometimes how they advance. And we got nine men sitting here, waiting with a Panzerfaust, ready to hit that Churchill if he gets close enough. And a defensive position here with infantry scouting the whole area. Panzer Grenadiers are finally under attack. They pinned down that anti-aircraft, or the anti-tank gun. And that anti-tank gun is pulling back, and so are we with the infantry. Very good. All right, very good. We'll have the half-track's going to come up and escort them. And that enemy tank has been eliminated. The left flank pressure has been relieved. And now if we eliminate that anti-aircraft gun, we've got good times. All right, look at this. Now the enemy is completely exposed. We can go ahead and cut off a whole chunk of their advance and start gaining the lead. So we can come up behind them and eliminate that 2-inch gun carrier. We can eliminate that anti-aircraft gun position. And we can go ahead and eliminate... Oh, look right here. We got a command unit. Beautiful. We can eliminate that command infantry. Oh, they did a great job of one-and-dunning my troops there. Oh, boy, two times. Wow, very good squad there. Wow. Do not underestimate infantry. They're as powerful as ever. Again, learning from the previous alpha that we had played, lessons learned on some things, and some things changing for the better, and some things for the worse. We got about 30 seconds left here. Let's go ahead and continue our advance then with this infantry. So yeah, look at that. Our vehicle advance stopped by just one command group. Look at that. Just like in Arnhem, British soldiers with the Piats just eliminating this vehicle here. Look at that. They've eliminated multiple vehicles, and that one is surrendering. Incredible. And that anti-aircraft gun pinning us down there, too. All right, now we've got access to new stuff here in a few seconds. I'm going to call out this BRM-21 and start eliminating a lot of their gun positions. You're going to see things going a lot better for us here in a second as we'll get access to more infantry and finally some better tanks. They've had a good advantage here for a while, so I'm just waiting for finally us to be able to get some advantage here. All right, finally, we can get that BF-109 up here. Where is that damn... oh, there it is. Anti-aircraft gun right there. All right, the anti-aircraft gun is eliminating our troops, so it's not focused on the air. Now it is, finally. And there goes the rockets. Boom, and they're pinned down. Fantastic. All right, let's get the tanks up here. Let's get a couple of tanks ready to rock on the left side. Enemy aircraft are out, but that's okay. We're turning back before they have a chance to eliminate us. And infantry's coming out on that side as well. Look at this. Right side's going well. We're pushing back on that right side. Center. Holding on with our teeth, basically. Just the skin of the teeth right there. So really being pushed back here against this medium AI. And a lot of lessons to learn here for all forces. This is my first time playing against the Scots as well. But this is playing out to be historically accurate. The SS putting up a hell of a fight. Young men and, you know, basically the best equipment that the Germans had against the Allies, who were heavily trained as well. So we'll see how it goes. We're going to try to flank these guys with some tanks. Let's go ahead and come in with the flanks here. And I think we got to get a... unfortunately, I don't think we have an aircraft to fight these guys. So let's get a couple of anti-aircraft guns up to make sure that they don't harass us for too long. Let's get an anti-aircraft gun up on the left side then to cover our advance. And let's get some more infantry out. We'll see how it goes here. Let's get out some more Panzer Grenadiers. We can actually get better Panzer Grenadiers in armored transports now that can really suppress enemy units as they advance. And look at that. That enemy AT gun, we're still harassing it. Finally engaging enemy troops there. So let's pull back a bit. Let that vehicle deal with it. They've got a huge front on us here. Look at that. We're eliminating a lot of their vehicles here. Or we have the chance to. All right, now we know there's enemy units up there, that command unit that was just decimating our advance. So I had that plan to hit the enemy in the flank, and boy, did that go to... boy, that went to hell in about a half second, didn't it? Everything can change in a blink of an eye on the battlefield, so you've got to have a backup plan to back up your backup plan. All right, enemy aircraft here. Let's go ahead and set up our AA gun and start shooting at her. Beautiful. Look at that. We set it up right underneath it. They're going to have to fall back in a matter of seconds. Uh-oh. Looks like the enemy's bringing up another Churchill, though. Churchill 5 moving up the road. Good thing we got that recon infantry there. And they've been able to spot anything coming down that road for the longest time. So we've really gotten lucky with that. All right, enemy aircraft falling back. That anti-aircraft gun's really doing a number there. We better eliminate that thing. All right, the looks like the command carrier is hauling ass out of here. Let's see if we can sneak up here and get that Churchill tank. All right, finally, we can start eliminating that anti-aircraft gun and start putting the British back on the, or the Scots on this side, ASAP. All right, over on the right side, looks like they're going to need some help. Looks like there's more enemy infantry approaching. Let's get that right flank, and let's advance in the center. We're going to need to get up a command panzer or something to see if we can hold that area. There's a lot of units coming. All right, let's get this unit bail out. Start hitting that tank. Go, boys. All right, Panzerfaust, fire. Anti-tank Panzerfaust, fire. Anytime, boys. There we go. Beautiful. All right, enemy tanks have been eliminated there. Six-pounder gun is now being deployed. We're going to eliminate that AT gun as well. All right, let's eliminate that vehicle there. Damn, squads just vanish. All right, there we go. Doing the best we can here, advancing with our infantry now again. All right, there we go. We've spotted some infantry. Let's make our advance onto those infantry with tank support. We have a Panzer IV J now right here, and we're starting to really put the push back onto the enemy. Enemy transport coming up. Looks like that six-pounder is trying to eliminate our tanks. Let's watch out for that. Enemy has 70% of the points. I've only got 46. They've got 1,400. And look at the amount of forces they're pushing up here. Incredible. Let's get into some of these positions here. Holding in a defensive position now. Hold back all those forces. Very good. Enemy infantry is going to be decimated there. Very good. All right, let's start cutting across. All right, start flanking that way. Start eliminating vehicles. All right, we're on the advance now. Hopefully we can catch them before we get cut off. There we go. The enemy's starting to fall on fronts. Enemy vehicle there. Let's get some more tanks out. Panzer IV J plus infantry. Oh boy, we got tanks exposed there. Panzer Grenadiers times two should do. Alright, Panzer IV J has been eliminated over on this side. Got one and done by I'm not sure what. A lot of one and dunning, a lot of good flanking and vehicles being killed with flanking, which is effective. It's always frustrating to get a flank on an enemy and then to have it fall. Speaking of fall, the enemy is now starting to fall back. They're going to win in 3 minutes and 30 seconds if we're not careful. Look at that, we're stopping all their tanks here. Let's go ahead and call out a strike on this tank here. Little Stuart. No anti-aircraft support on the right side. Fire those rockets. There we go. Beautiful. Enemy tank's now going to fall back. It gives us an opportunity to put our infantry in buildings. Oh, these guys weren't even in a building. Sometimes it's hard to tell whether or not your troops are actually in cover. All right, very good. We're starting to push back. A lot of Scottish infantry all over. Let's get another tank up. A lot of light enemy vehicles here. A lot of light infantry. Let's get out on foot, boys. Start pushing them back. All right, let's get that vehicle. All right. Oh, wow, look at that. What is firing that? Is that that two-pounder? What is that? Some sort of a... Wow, I'm not actually sure what that is, but that thing is, like, firing all day. That must be a priest of some sort or something. Possibly a rabbi. Not sure. Wow, look at all the troops on the right side. Look at that. Incredible. Enemy troops are all over us. All right, but we're pushing back on the left side now. Keep the advance up. All right, they're going to win in 4 minutes if we're not careful. Let's continue our advance. All right, enemy friendly vehicles are retreating. Wow, we're caught out in the open with a lot of these vehicles now. Let's get some more tanks up. We need some more points. We're going to get 115 points here. So the more territory that you control, of course, the better it is for you. The more vehicles you'll be able to call out, that kind of thing. Let's continue to push up the front. Oh, enemy anti-tank over here. All right, let's go left side. All right, we're going left with our tank. So you have to have a command over the meta and the micro at the same time. Yeah, you'll lose vehicles like that quite quickly. All right, we call out yet another another rocket bomber. Let's call in another rocket strike on these troops. Let's see if we can... Look at all that infantry there, pinning us down like insanity here. Rocket strikes pinning down those enemy units. That's going to delay their advance immensely. All right, we're going to flank this anti-tank gun here with our tanks here. Enemy infantry here is exposed. Another Churchill pushing up. It's a command Churchill. Go toe-to-toe with that thing. Let's see what we can do. All right. Wow, plenty of enemy infantry everywhere. Wow, going straight in is not going to work. You cannot take on AT guns. And that Humber is just blinding our troops. Incredible. Over on the right side, they're still holding him back. All right, friendly forces are pushing up here. Looks like we captured an enemy supply vehicle. All right, let's eliminate that AT gun and start hitting Bedford supply trucks. Let's actually hit that command, Stuart. If we can do it in the next 45 seconds, we might be able to cut off this whole flank here. Go, boys. Look at that. Incredible. Even though we're losing, it is playing out historically to how it would be. Eventually, forces are going to have to retreat, and I really want to be able to show off some of the bigger vehicles here, but you've got to get to the third phase in order to do it. So the longer the battle goes on, the better for everybody. Let's see if we can get that command vehicle pinned down. Oh, there we go. Tank's starting to get it on the flank. This Panzer IV J peeking between the buildings here. Getting a good flank on that enemy vehicle. A lot of players are complaining about falling back being too quick of a thing, too. Definitely a constant factor in the battlefield. Look at that. Wow, a total defeat as well, but I would say a total victory. I am happy to be playing that one. Medium AI is quite the challenge, and so is it going to be a challenge as you play with and against your friends in this one. Highly recommended. Now, I've got a lot of things to learn, so if you have any recommendations for me, and if you've played yourself, go ahead and give me some tips down below on what you think I should change in that deck there. We'll be showing off how to make a deck, and I'll be showing you how to make that one and make it a little stronger, and we'll be seeing that very soon. So for now, in the pre-order, you can play as the United States Armored, the Scottish. You can play as the Germans, both infantry, and also Panzer Grenadiers, or actually the SS Panzer Division that you've seen, but also the Brits, different types of Americans, different types of German groups will be brought into this one. I love this, man. That was great. I loved playing the impending doom of the Allied advance. And just fighting against the Scots, we did very good, so we were able to delay them there for quite some time. Very good. A very fantastic game, and I can't wait to show you more of this fantastic one, of course, known as Steel Division, Normandy 44. I'll see you folks as we make a deck next, and we'll be giving it a test. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.